With CoPrA 11, the flexibility in creating a device link linearization has been greatly improved. Adding a dedicated ink limitation with the option to set custom ink limits allows for user-defined, channel-specific ink limiting. The calculation defines the method for calculating the colorimetric linearity. Select the desired mode and the appropriate ink limitation. There are three different methods to choose from. When choosing automatic, the applied ink limit is calculated based on the measurement data and is displayed grayed out in the maximum value section for each other. Selecting custom shows the automatically calculated values for the ink limits. These values can be edited in the corresponding input fields of the ink limit section. The profile filter section has been redesigned to be more compact, leaving more space for the profile list. All columns can now be sorted by clicking on the column title. New addition to the profile list is the date column, which displays the creation date of the respective profile. The Gamut tab has been revised and enhanced, allowing the comparison of two profiles in the 3D view and up to three profiles in the 2D view. The Gamut view has also been enlarged. In the 2D view, the lightness slider has been removed, and it is now possible to change the lightness with the mouse wheel or by entering the value directly in the input field. The gamut of the selected profile can be compared to the gamut of up to two comparison profiles selected in the profile selection. These comparison profiles can either be set via the context menu of the profile list or via the load option of the context menu. The color of the outlines of the individual profiles can be changed by clicking the color field and using the tools provided. In the 3D view, the zoom slider has been removed. It is now possible to change the zoom factor with the mouse wheel via a shortcut or by entering the value directly in the input field. Context menu that provides additional viewing options can be opened by right-clicking on the gamut view. The option last used in the gamut view are saved and applied again when CoPrA is restarted. A new function in the DeviceLink tool is the option to switch between curves and gamut view, as in the printer profiling tools. The gamut view reflects the conversion between the source and target profile. The gamut view shows changes to the gamut shape immediately when settings are changed and provides a real-time preview of the expected conversion between source and target profile. All settings, such as rendering intents, exceptions, black point, etc., are considered and displayed in the gamut view. With the adjustable overlay tool, you can define a resizable comparison area of the image preview in which you can compare the image with the target profile using the defined color management workflow from the source profile via the rendering intent. The toggle preview button switches the entire visible preview area so that either the image rendered with the source profile or the target profile is shown. New preview scaling options have been added to the image conversion preview area. The fit image option scales the image to the maximum size of the full image in height or width, depending on the image orientation. Fit width scales the image to the maximum width recommended for images in portrait format. The fit height option scales the image to the maximum height recommended for images in landscape format. The batch overview window has been completely revised. All post-processing options have been moved to a context menu. This provides a clearer overview and a more efficient handling of subsequent tasks. Different processes within a profiling job have been combined under a single higher-level parent job with a unique index number. The profile name is shown in the column type of this parent job. For example, the printer profiles created, the profile reports, the preview profiles, and the multicolor variants are listed under the parent job. Additional information such as color space and profile types can also be found in the type column. Additional tasks can be assigned to each job within the parent job using the context menu. For example, additional variants can be calculated that were not yet calculated in the first step.
For more information on CoPrA, please visit our website.